Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's start the press conference for the Paris E-Prix of 2019. I'd like to welcome Xavier Mestarin, head of performance from DS Automobiles, Dilbag Gill, team principal of Mahindra Racing, and James Barkley from Panasonic Jaguar Racing, up onto the stage for our first part of the press conference. Very good afternoon, gentlemen. Xavier, we'll start with you, seeing as you've sat down first. Welcome to Paris.
I say welcome to Paris.
As the only French manufacturer based in France, how are you feeling this weekend? A lot of pressure on you, or it's just the same as every other race?
Yes, as I always say, we prepare all the race like the other. But of course, I leave from my office yesterday afternoon, so we were on the sims with our driver yesterday morning, and 10 minutes after we were here on the track. So it's a first a very good feeling because the place is fantastic. It's one of the best places for the Formula E. And of course, to have all our colleagues, family, who will support us during all the weekend. It's another pressure, but it's a good one. It's a good feeling to be had, of course.
And how do you rate the DS Techeetah season so far? One win, André Lotterer was on the podium last time, leading the team's championship, but the drivers' championship is a little bit more difficult?
Difficult, I don't know if it's the right name. The battle is very nice, seven races, seven winners. I think that since the beginning of the race, the pace of our car is very good. We know that we can win on all races. Of course, it's difficult to do it. But I think that everybody made mistakes. We made mistakes, the driver, the other team, the manufacturer. And this is the reason why it's so difficult to make good results. But we are just after the middle of the championship. We are leading the team championship. For the driver, we are only 3 points to the leading, so it's not very far away. The championship is still very open. The most important thing is to know that we have the pace. We know that we are able to fight for the final victory for both titles, so this is the most important thing.
And every year we've come to Paris, we see the push for clean mobility grow more and more. How does that affect DS?
I think it's a very important point for DS as a manufacturer. We already take the decision that all the new model we sell has an electric version. So this is the reason why we are involved in this series. It's to improve our knowledge in all the electrified vehicle. We are here to accelerate the R&D and to work with our colleagues from the road car department. So this is very, very important. And the regulation is very good because we are very close to what we have on our road car. So it's important to improve our car in the Formula E so that we can, a few years after, use the same technology on our car.
Okay, thank you. Best of luck for the weekend. Dilbag Gill, turning to you, team principal of Mahindra Racing. Round 8 of the season, and Jerome is at the top of the driver's standings. That must be very exciting for you and the team.
Yeah, I think it is good fun because I think every lap, the driver's rankings change this year, so it's good to be leading, but it's really tight, as Javier was saying, and I think everyone notices it. So I think the challenge this year is going to be really good fun, and it's going to go to the last lap in New York.
And what do you make of Pascal's season? It's been so impressive at times, but then the results aren't quite there. Is there anything you can do to make that happen, or is it just a case of waiting?
Well, I think Pascal is going to show his caliber, which he has already started this thing, and there's a lot more races this year. And I expect Pascal to be one of the winners in the next few races.
And has this felt the most competitive season in Formula E since you've been here since the start?
Oh, yes, yeah. I'm one of the few guys who's been here for all the 53 races so far. And by far, this has been the most competitive season because I don't think anyone can decide or predict where this is going to get to.
Okay, great. Best of luck with the weekend. And James Barkley, seven winners in seven races, and you made it the 7 out of 7. Was the feeling happiness, or was it relief, or a bit of both?
Yeah, I think you could say a bit of both. Relief in the sense that we knew it was there, and I'd said it previously. We had a fast race car, and it was just about been able to execute the weekend fully and show that. So relief that we'd be able to make that step change, particularly in the qualifying performance, and that kind of put us in a great place to then capitalise on what we believe we have, on a strong race car we believe we had. And that kind of came, showed, I would say, itself fully in Rome. So, I'm very pleased, very proud of the group. We have fundamentally the same group of people that with the team that started and we entered in season three. We had a blank sheet of paper. We didn't have an existing motorsport program, so we really kind of have built this team and learnt in public. That's the approach we've taken, and really proud of what we've achieved. And it was a great race. I mean, a very, very close race with Andre. He was, he was always very difficult to race against. The car's very quick as well, I think attack mode played out really well. So I think we were also pleased that it wasn't a win which we lucked our way into. We generally earned and won through the pace of the car and some great driving by Mitch.
And you had the pace in the car in Rome last year. Was that something that you were expecting going into the weekend?
Obviously, so much difference between the cars now. You can't really compare, but definitely had fond memories of Rome last year. Mitch, as a driver, also, that was a key turning point for him as well. That was one of those lessons you learn that makes you even stronger. And I think that has made him even stronger. Some of those lessons last year in season four, and for us as a team as well. And he executed the race brilliantly from qualifying to the race as well. He had one chance to make the move. He made it work. It played out really well for our points. It was a great week for Jaguar. We also won World Car of the Year, World Design Car of the Year, and World Green Car of the Year. So, capping off the win, it was a fantastic week for us at the brand.
And Alex Lynn made his debut with the team, coming from the track where he'd struggled last season. But he seemed to do well, although it didn't quite come together as a weekend for him.
Yeah, I think you can't underestimate the size of the challenge coming in at this point with such a competitive year, as you and Dilbag have just said. Everyone has had all that mileage in the car now. He did a great job. I think a fantastic job. He came in very pragmatic. He got his head down, qualified in the top 10. Unfortunate from our point of view, we just made a slight error there on the power cap with the jump, and that kind of caught us out. But through the job he had to do, he executed really well to get to that top 10 for quali. And he had a good race and moved forward and made up some places. So, he's done we're very proud of the job he's done, and I'm looking forward to seeing how he gets on this weekend. And, great to have him on board.
And just to where we heard it from Xavier, the importance of electric mobility, you can talk more about the I-Pace if you want, because, that must be an important part for Jaguar too.
Yeah, it is. I think what is incredible about Formula E is, wind back to the start of the championship and the kind of growing awareness and interest in electric vehicles. The championship fundamentally is designed to showcase the benefits of electric vehicle, both from an environmental point of view, but actually also a performance point of view. And in that time since the championship's been launched, we have now an all-electric car, which is, World Car of the Year as well. And that has shown that times are changing. And, we at Jaguar and Land Rover, it's a key part of our future, but along with every manufacturer in Formula E. So, we're a generation, I always say, that's like forebears before us went from steam to combustion. We're going from combustion to electrification, and that's really exciting to see that change happening and be part of that change.
Yeah, cool. Best of luck for the weekend. Thank you.